New astronomers, Michael here, and thank you for tuning into my channel. I'm going to be quite honest with you, I haven't had a chance to go stargazing with my telescope this season at all. And that is because of a number of reasons. Number one, I haven't had a chance to bring my telescope upstairs. My back had been hurting and I just don't have space in my car. Blah, blah, blah. Well, in this episode, I'm going to try to eliminate some of these excuses by introducing or reintroducing the option of using binoculars as an option to new and existing astronomers. So I hope you enjoy this video. Well, besides allowing you to spy on your neighbors, binoculars are versatile tools in astronomy with a number of advantages. And in this video, I'm going to point out 5 advantages over telescopes, which will hopefully make you appreciate it. Number one, they're small and lightweight. The average pair of binoculars measure around 6 by 8 inches. This is small enough to fit in your car's glove box compartment or the center console. And unlike my 12-inch Dobsonian, there is no need for me to clear my back seat ahead of time to load it into my car. And when you get to my age, lifting a 45-pound Dobsonian becomes such a chore after just a few nights of stargazing. A pair of binoculars, on the other hand, such as the ones I have here, weigh 2 pounds. This is lighter than my bag of eyepieces. And also, if it has straps, you can sling it around your neck and that'll free up both of your hands. Number two, they are easy to transport. My Dobsonian takes me around 15 minutes to tear down, load, and set up, and another 15 minutes in reverse on my way home. All the while, trying to be very careful not to put a scratch on it. My binoculars, on the other hand, don't need to be set up or torn down, and it's also made to be rugged. I only need to adjust its focus, and even that takes just a few seconds. My binoculars are also easier to use all year round, whereas my telescope is going to be quite a challenge to set up during the winter. I like to store my Dobsonian during the winter and it could take up quite a large footprint. My binoculars, on the other hand, are very small, so I can store them pretty much anywhere. Number three, you probably have one already. You don't need to be an astronomer to own binoculars. In the past, maybe you bought a pair just for bird watching or checking what's happening across the lake. Go ahead and check your closet, check your basement, maybe you have one kicking around. Maybe you can borrow from somebody that you know who has one. Otherwise, check out number four. Number four, they are less expensive. My first telescope cost me around $250, and to a lot of prospective astronomers, especially young ones, this could be quite a turnoff. So they end up buying a $100 cheap telescope and often get discouraged by the results. This is because cheap telescopes usually come with cheap optics and mounts. Well, you get what you pay for. But for the same price as a cheap telescope, you can get yourself a good pair of binoculars. And I think a good pair of binoculars offers better value than a cheap telescope. And finally, number five, they make it easier to find objects. You can think of binoculars as finder scopes on your telescope on steroids, because not only are the optics are of better quality, but you get two of them. So there is no need for you to cover up one eye or close one eye, because you can use both. Objects also appear right side up instead of upside down or mirrored, which makes them more intuitive. And like finder scopes, they offer a wide field of view. Besides the moon and planets, you can check out the Milky Way clouds and double stars. And on a good night, you can observe distant galaxies such as the Andromeda Galaxy and star clusters like M13. Obviously, they also have their shortcomings, such as the lack of aperture and magnification, but binoculars are usually overlooked by new astronomers because when they think of astronomy, they automatically think about telescopes. In reality, though, binoculars have an important place in stargazing, and a lot of experienced astronomers have a pair along with them out in the field. And in fact, I always bring these with me and use it interchangeably with my telescope, or when my back isn't ready to carry 45 pounds of goodness. Well, that'll be all for this episode, but if you have any other comments that you'd like to share, please add them to the comments section. And if you like this video, please hit that like button, or better yet, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in my next video. As always, clear skies, and thanks for watching.